Sometimes I get enough of having to listen to Nathan Oakley, Quantum Eraser, Widget Gets It, 10th Man and the like in order to make my videos. So I decided to look at Quantum Eraser's website, globeterminator.com. I saw the same old nonsense there in the childish layout with the silly emojis and the stupid pubescent insults, but at least I wouldn't have to listen to the irritating voice of this self-proclaimed genius. He posted 7 of what he calls his flat earth proofs. In a series of 7 videos, I will pulverize each and every one of them. This is part 4, Bolivian salt flats. These flurfers make life of a flat earth debunker so easy. Quantum Eraser states that the Bolivian salt flats show a relief of less than 1 meter over an area of 9,000 square kilometers. There he's telling his first lie. Let's look at the actual paper and find in the survey description that the measurements on the Bolivian salt flats were not made over an area of 9,000 square kilometers. They were made over an area of 45 times 54 kilometers, or just 2,430 square kilometers. This is an indication that QE hasn't read the paper, but we are used to that already. Another indication that he hasn't read it is this table, where it says WGS84. This is the World Geodetic Coordinate System. It is the reference system used by the Global Positioning System, and it consists of a reference ellipsoid, a standard coordinate system, and a geoid. Further on, the paper mentions the EGM-96 geoid model as a reference. The EGM-96, or the Earth Gravitational Model, is part of a series of geopotential models of the Earth used together with WGS84 to establish elevations. So all measurements are based on the Earth being an ellipsoid. And that's where the second misunderstanding by Quantum Eraser comes from. He used the term vertical relief as in change in elevation. He thinks that no change in elevation means flat. It doesn't. Elevation is measured in relation to the geoid. Therefore, no change in elevation means just that. No change in elevation, thus following the surface of the geoid. And the surface of a geoid most certainly is not flat. It is that of a geoid. He goes on and on calculating the drop over 62 miles and continues with his modus tollens argument. And of course he is wrong again. The measurements of the Bolivian salt flats didn't measure drop, they measured elevation change in relation to the geoid model of the spherical Earth. This elevation change is less than 1 meter, so the Earth is a geoid, not flat.
How stupid can anyone be?
Oh well, it's just Quantum Eraser, who definitely has deserved his nickname, Questionable Education.